What's up, everyone? Today I'll be showing you how to install the MTX Roadthunder Soundbar Plus. We're going to be installing this on a motorcycle, but since this is a universal item, installation procedure may vary. First, you'll want to remove the seat for routing the wires, and be sure to disconnect the battery to prevent any mishaps. Begin by roughly laying out the wires to ensure that you have adequate length and to determine where you want to hide the wires. Put the wire harness in place, but don't secure anything yet. Exactly where you run the harness is up to you, just be sure that the wire harness will not be pinched or melted once it is fully installed. Decide where you want to mount the soundbar. In this case, we're going to mount it hanging from the handlebar on this motorcycle. Next, pre-install the soundbar clamps and then determine where you want the mounting clamps to go on the machine. Included with the Roadthunder Soundbar Plus are 5 sets of clamps ranging from 7/8 of an inch to 1.5 inches. Use the appropriate size mounting clamps for your application. In this case, we're using the 1-inch clamps for these handlebars. We recommend utilizing the supplied transparent film to install the mounting clamps without damaging the mounting surface. Remove the film after the clamp is installed. Loosely install all of the mounting hardware. If you're installing the Soundbar Plus on something that moves, like these handlebars, make sure that you have the full range of motion and that the soundbar doesn't interfere with anything nearby. Make final adjustments and fully install the hardware. The Soundbar Plus is a directional speaker, so ensure it's aimed toward the rider before completing installation. If fine-tuning is needed, simply loosen the speaker clamp bolt and rotate the soundbar accordingly. There are 4 wires within the wire harness. The red wire goes to the battery positive, the black wire goes to the battery negative, the orange wire is connected to an accessory or switch-powered wire, and the blue wire is for additional amplifiers, which we will not be using in this application. Determine the switch power wire you want to use and install the provided T-tap onto that wire. Plug in the orange wire to the T-tap you just installed. Next, route the red and black wire to your battery and connect the black to the negative terminal and the red to the positive terminal. Test the soundbar by turning it on to make sure it works before completing the install. After you have ensured everything works properly, go ahead and do the final routing of the wire harness and secure it with the provided zip ties. Once again, make sure that the wire harness is routed so that it will not be pinched or melted. For more information on the Roadthunder Soundbar Plus and all of our audio products, visit curryocken.com or reach out to our tech team with any questions.
We go where you go. Everywhere and anywhere. Purposefully built to stand up to the elements. Designed to perform under any condition. Built for the moments that matter. For the rugged and the relentless. We are the soundtrack for adventure. This is purpose-built audio. This is Rockford Fosgate.
Hey, it's Justin with Blue Wave Marine Audio, and today we're doing a video on the M7.0 and 9.0 CX3, which is our third generation 7 and 9 from the M line by Blue Wave. So as you can see, the 7.0 and 9.0 come in silver, white, and black. Cool feature is the grills do come off. So if you want to paint the grill, it's very simple to do. Pop out the tweeter mesh grill, paint your color of choice, three little dabs of super glue, insert the mesh back in, pop on the grill, you're good to go. So we've got a nice option there. Another cool feature, if you look at the back of our grills, this is for the 7s, 9s, or 10s in the M line. You can see that groove right around the backside here and these fasteners and this wire route. That's for the SG LED. So you can actually add the LED kit to any of the M line speakers, 7, 9, or 10, which gives you the ability to tie into your lighting system or one that you choose to add in the future. And it's capable of RGB or individual color. So it gives you a really nice variety between the factory colors, custom paint, RGB, or solid color lighting. Gives you a lot of options. So far as physical specs, the 7, it is 7 and 3/8 OD. ID, your cutout, is 5 3/4. Okay, so that's gonna allow you to fit a 7.0 in almost every application that you're able to fit a 6.5. We do thousands of installs here. We're 20 years in the installation field here at Blue Wave and our sister company, Waves and Wheels. So everything we've built has been around hands-on experience and engineering experience combined. So you're not going to have a problem dropping a 7 into a 6.5 location. The depth is right at 3 inches. And the cool thing is you can also drop a 7 into a 7.7 application with our retrofit kit. So we see a lot of boats out there that have a 7.7. They come out from the factory with that, and we've got customers that want to go to the Blue Wave. So what we did is we came up with a 7.7 retrofit kit. The 7.7 drops right in to the 7.7 factory holes, and then the 7.0 drops into the retrofit kit, makes the install really easy. So you can upgrade from a 6.5 to a 7 or a 7.7 to a 7. Far as the 9 physical size, your 8 7/8 OD. ID, you're at 7.5. So slightly larger than your traditional 8. Not by much. Again, if you've got an 8 and you want to go to what we consider as the 9.0 based off the grill size and the cone size versus what the industry standard is, you can upgrade really easily to a 9.0. And you can see the depth on the 9.0, we use a Y35 magnet, so there's not a monster magnet underneath. It's a very efficient, very strong magnet without having a big bulky size. You only need 3.5 inches of mounting depth. So you can fit these in a lot of applications. A couple other cool features, power-wise. We really suggest for the 7 and the 9, a minimum of 75 watts RMS. Peak power, far as peak RMS, continuous power, we highly suggest running 100 watts. That's our ideal application, 100 watts per driver, RMS power. You're going to get really the full synergy and sound quality of the 7 and the 9 with that kind of power, especially when it's tuned correctly. And speaking of tuning, one thing that we're really known for with Blue Wave is our sound quality. That's really where we focus. A lot of people can do loud, we do loud, they get loud, but sound quality is where we feel we really step above. And one thing, we'll start with the 7. So traditionally, your 6.5 to a 7.7 range, you're going to be looking in that 85 to 100 hertz frequency range as far as setting your high pass on your amplifier. Our 7 can play from down to 70 hertz the whole way up to 30,000 hertz. So what this does is this gives you a huge range of music, okay? You can go down to, again, 70. What we suggest for most applications, what we see is the most common out of all the installs, is 72 to 75. We talk to a lot of our dealers, and people that have installed the product and they love it, and we feel them out a little more and find out that they've actually got them tuned to somewhere between 80 to 100. And we say, hey, bring the frequency down just a little bit. Give it a try, call us back. We always, 9 times out of 10, we always get a call back, and they're blown away by the difference of the sound quality. What it does is it really allows the suspension to get working, and you get that full effect that these drivers were designed for. The 9 can actually drop down to 60 hertz. So we suggest in most applications, 65. So 65, 75 are your two safe zones. You can go a little lower, like down to 60 if need be. You can go down to 70 if need be, but 65, 75 is going to be your two ranges, and you're going to get some incredible synergy and sound quality. So that gives you a good feel for the tuning setup. Far as some of the attributes that we've put into Blue Wave for sound quality and durability, of course, we're not going to give away all mom's family recipe, but the main features are, as you can see, if you're looking through these speakers, you can kind of see, as you can see right through them. Okay, so that's called a vented design. What it does is it keeps the spider and the coil extremely cool. Anybody that knows anything about motors, heat's bad. So sealing these all up on the backside, you're gonna lose efficiency. It requires way more power to run. Just a loss of efficiency and sound quality and performance all around. So we've built a very durable product that can withstand the saltwater environment that's open on both sides of the spider. Now the internals of the tweeter and the upper coil are all sealed, but the inside you can see is vented. That's going to keep your product cool. Another thing we do to keep efficiency and keep the product cool is we add aluminum short rings, which again, you don't see a lot in car and marine audio. And what that does is it's basically a heat sinker on the coil, helps dissipate heat. And then one other feature is we do ferrofluid injection. So ferrofluid injection in the coils. So between those three features, the speakers are gonna stay cool, your amp's gonna be happy, they're gonna run all day. And it really makes for an incredible performing product. Crossovers are formally coated. Even the connectors, if you notice our connectors here, these aren't standard butt connectors, they're heat shrink. So for an install, you can connect them, heat the connector, and now your connection is sealed. So it really makes for a nice all-around product. Another thing too, all of our speakers have exceeded a 2,000-hour salt fog test. We've actually had some that have ran for an entire year, which is, if you do the math, is a lot more than 2,000 hours. So at the end of the day, that kind of sums it up for our 7 and 9.0.